My apologies. It turned out I was the one who needed a little bit more time. Is there anyone who would like to talk us through the first question? Not all at the same time, please. It doesn't have to be a definite answer, but a route to an answer is also fine.
Yeah, I think I may be able to start on question 1A.
Okay.
Yeah. So we know that the absorption coefficient of the substance is 100 millimeters to the power minus 1. And the other given answers, of course. But I was thinking about using two formulas from the slides of the previous time, actually. So there is one where you can calculate the absorption of a solution, where the absorption coefficient of that solution will be the volume fraction multiplied with the absorption coefficient of the substance. So that would be 0.5 times mu A. And I want to use that in combination with the fraction of the absorption coefficient of the substance. And the absorption coefficient of the solution, because they are related to each other with an exponential, and also with the absorption coefficient of the substance. And then you can substitute the absorption coefficient of the solution. And then I think we have all the numbers we need to calculate it. I only didn't do the calculation yet.
Okay. No, but I think you're right. That's exactly right. There were actually three formulas that you could use. There was one that calculated the absorption coefficient of the solution, one of the suspension, and one for the ratio. So it doesn't really matter which order you do it. So this is not a ratio, but the two formulas I was referring to are given here. So the absorption coefficient of the suspension of particles, that is the top left formula, has the volume fraction in there as a parameter, FV. It has the absorption coefficient of the substance that is in the particle, so that was the given one in there. That's mu AM in the formula and mu A in the question, to make it a little bit of a puzzle. And then there is R, the kind of the size of the particle. And that is always a little bit tricky, because at one point we assumed that the particle was cubical. At some points we will assume that the particle is spherical. But let's say this is an effective size. And then the formula on the right-hand side gives you the absorption coefficient of a solution if the same amount of molecules that were at first contained in the particle would then be released into a solution. So if we take the numbers that are here, and please correct me if I'm wrong, I try to choose them a little bit convenient. So if the absorption coefficient is 100 per millimeter and the effective size of a particle is 0.01 millimeter, then the product is 1. The exponential of that is 0.37, so 1 minus that exponential is 0.63. And if we combine that with the volume fraction and fill it in the top left formula, we get an absorption coefficient for the suspension of 13.6 millimeter. Did anyone get to this number? Not really.
Yeah, I got the same answer.
Okay. Well, I always want to don't want to rule out that I made a little mistake, but good. Is everybody happy with this calculation and explanation? Or is there anything that is not entirely clear? not getting those. So that is.
Wait, my bad. I think the 3 and the 1 in the 13 should be flipped. So it's 31.6.
You sure?
Yeah.
Yes, I also had 31.6.
This is our moment to have a collective check of this calculation. So
I
which
think it's a typo, because in the last line you have 0.5 times 0.63 divided by 10. So it's basically 0.63 divided by 2, which is not 13. So I think it's just
that is true. Okay. Then I made a typo. I will I'll correct this in the and I'll upload the corrected slides. I'm sorry. Then again, you said you got the same answer. So someone said he got the same answer. So where did this go wrong? Yeah. Okay. Sure. I'm sorry. Okay. Well, this was bound to happen. I'm glad it happened already in the second class. Okay, let's go on to the other question. If then all these particles would be somehow so they are in a cuvette, you did the measurement, and then all of a sudden we could break the particles. I don't know, you could ultrasonically destroy them, for example. What would be the well, the answer is already there, so that's not really an exciting question anymore. And I have to be really careful that the answer to the third question is not on there. So for the second, so let's skip to the second question. We again have a cuvette that is filled with a solution of molecules. So now with the solution of molecules with a given absorption coefficient, and now all these molecules are magically contained into particles. Particles have size 25 micrometer, volume fraction of 40%, 0.4, and we do an absorption measurement on that same cuvette. Can you now predict what the absorption coefficient will be if we do a measurement on this suspension?
Well, I think I got this one wrong, because if we break the particles, then the effective size won't be 10 nanometers micrometers anymore. But I use the formula, the ratio between the absorption coefficient in a suspension and the absorption coefficient mu r. And that would be the ratio between 1 minus e to the power of minus mu r times r over mu r times r, and I got it that it would be 0.63 times mu r, which would be 63 millimeters at the power of minus 1. But I think I got it wrong, right?
Anyone else want to chime in?
I think Vlad, you're only off by a factor of 10. I got 6.3 per micrometer, using the same equation we did in question 1A. Though then again, I had the previous number. I read that wrong too. So hey, you never know.
Anyone else? Yes, of course, Chen, you're right. There should be a minus in the exponentials as well. So I will correct the slide. To be honest, I just made the slides for this answer this morning, and I guess I was a little bit too hasty. So I'll correct them and I'll post them on Canva. So this is what I got. Oh, here we go. So we have we measured a this already contains a typo, I see. Okay, so this is this is not the best. Okay, let's do this without looking at the numbers all too well, too closely. We had a absorption coefficient of 20 per millimeter for the molecules in a suspension. If we would encapsulate that into particles, which would then contain a volume fraction of 40%, that would mean that because the molecules are now contained, just like the experiment where we put all the molecules to the side or to the front, that would mean that we would now have an absorption coefficient inside the particles of 50 per millimeter. So basically that is, I think, 20 divided by 1.25. And if we then use the in this case the most right hand formula for the ratio of the solution and suspension, we would get a ratio of 0.57, and then multiplying that out, because we had 20 for the solution, multiplying that out, we would get about 11 for the suspension. But I realize I made a couple of mistakes in the first calculation anyway, so I'll recheck this. Please do the same thing, and let me know. Then, so you're saying mu A and Q2 is mu A of the solution. Yeah, that was the idea. Yeah, that was the idea. So again, you in this kind of problem, you have three values for the absorption coefficient. You have the absorption coefficient of, so there is always the same number of molecules, but you have the absorption coefficient if you would measure purely on the substance that is in the particles. So basically, if you could do an absorption transmission measurement on only one particle, then you would get mu A subscript M, medium, molecular, whatever. If you put that substance into particles, put these particles in a solution with a given volume fraction, you would measure mu A suspension. And if you would then somehow break these particles, so you would still have the same amount of molecules as a volume fraction, you would get mu A solution, and these three numbers will all be different, and the question is how do you translate from one to the other. Is it a little bit clearer now, or is it more confusing? So I'm seeing a little bit wondered faces on the screen.
Yeah, for me it's a bit more clear. It's just that sometimes in the question it's not entirely clear if so in question one it was mu A for a particle, and here it's question is for a solvent.
I'm sorry, I must admit I just thought up this question this morning, and so maybe I was a little bit rushed to put it into the slides. So I will reformulate it more correctly, and then I'll put it on Canvas. But more importantly, is the concept clear?
I'm still not sure how you got these values. I mean, mu A solution over the volume fraction, wouldn't that be 20 over
0.4. Yeah, but isn't that, doesn't that evaluate to 50 or did I even make a mistake there? At this moment, I'm not ruling anything out.
Oh, no, no, excuse me. And then, okay. Yeah, sorry.
Thanks. No, that's okay, that's okay.
And then the ratio of suspension over the solution absorption coefficient. Which calculus is this?
Yeah, that is the calculation from the formula at right at top of the slide that you see now.
Oh, okay.
The most right formula. So, so basically, what we did here was we did a measurement first at actually of mu A solution. But since we knew the volume fraction, we could calculate mu A molecular the mu A of the substance inside the particles. And once we know that, we can and we know the size of the particles, we can calculate the ratio between suspension and solution.
Okay.
And that for me got 0.57. So then going back to the mu A solution that we knew, which was 20 per millimeter times 0.57 I made a few typos in here. I'm sorry, I was a little bit too hasty. It's 11.4 per millimeter. Okay. Is it okay to move on? I'll correct the typos and post the actual question on Canvas. Is that okay, or do you want to discuss this more? Okay. I see a few thumbs up. Thanks. This is the assignment that I actually gave to you as homework. Then the question is, did you work on it? Was that clear? I'm slowly beginning to fear that my line of questioning is not always that clear.
So I did work on it, though for me, the final figure that I got at the second point, I didn't get the absorption. What's the term called?
The flattening.
I couldn't get the absorption flattening. So I think I got either something in my coding wrong or.
Anyone else who either worked on it or ran into trouble or solved it?
No, just have a small question. So I didn't really succeed in solving the question, but there was one abbreviation, HCT, and was that for the volume fraction